Hello dear students, so today in this lecture we are going to discuss about the another type of plant cells, plant tissues, and these are known as simple permanent tissues. As you know, we have already discussed that in plants, as the growth is not uniform, it is localized to some particular regions. That's why all the plant tissues are divided into two categories, like dividing and non-dividing. The dividing tissues are known as meristematic tissues, about which we have already discussed. And if you talk about the non-dividing tissues, which are known as permanent tissues, so you know that permanent tissues are also of two types. One is simple permanent and another one is complex permanent. Simple permanent are those which are made up of only one type of cells. So today we are going to discuss about the simple permanent tissues. Simple permanent tissues, as you know, they are made up of only one type of cells. And as you know that simple permanent tissues are further divided into two categories, supportive and protective. So today in this lecture we'll be discussing about the supportive type of permanent tissues. And as you know, the supportive type of permanent tissues are what? There are three supportive permanent tissues, and these are of course parenchyma, collenchyma, and sclerenchyma. So three types of supportive permanent tissues are found in case of plants: parenchyma, collenchyma, and sclerenchyma, the details of which we will be discussing here in this lecture. So first of all, how are these permanent tissues formed? So but the permanent tissues are formed by the process known as tissue differentiation. So what is tissue differentiation? When a meristematic cell divides, matures, and loses the ability to divide so that it is converted to a permanent tissue, then it is known as tissue differentiation. So how we define tissue differentiation? It is the process by which a mature meristematic cell acquires a particular function shape and loses the ability to divide. So this process is known as tissue differentiation, and this tissue differentiation is responsible for formation of the permanent tissues. So the process in which a meristematic cell divides, it matures, it acquires a specific shape and function, and of course it loses the ability to divide. Now this process known as tissue differentiation. So in this process, the first type of simple permanent cells or tissues about which we are going to discuss here is that is parenchyma. If you look at the parenchyma cells, what are these? These are of course the living cells having thin walls, large intercellular spaces with one large vacuole or 2 to 3 small vacuoles and dense cytoplasm. So that is the property of parenchyma cells. If we look at the features of parenchyma cell, first of all these parenchyma cells are living. They are having thin cell walls. They are having large intercellular spaces. And they have one vacuole, or if there is one vacuole, then it is large in size. If there are more number of vacuoles, 2-3 number of vacuoles, then these vacuoles are small in size. And of course, their cytoplasm is dense. And if you look at the shape of the cells, these are oval or round shaped cells. Right, so here we can see like this, the parenchyma cells are closely placed with thin walls having large vacuoles and of course a nucleus which is peripheral, and as you can see here there are large intercellular spaces. That is how the parenchyma looks like. And if you look at the location of parenchyma, this parenchyma is found in all soft parts of the plant, like flowers, fruits, etc. So you can see parenchyma in any of the soft part of the plant. It may be in the flowers, it may be in the roots, it may be in the fruits, it may be in the roots, it may be in the soft stem. Everywhere you can observe these parenchyma. And of course, in this parenchyma also, there is some differentiation is there. So here we are having further two modifications of parenchyma. If we look at the modifications of parenchyma, one which have here is known as chlorenchyma. So one type of parenchyma is known as chlorenchyma. So when parenchyma cells containing chlorophyll and ability to perform photosynthesis. So those parenchyma cells that contain chlorophyll and that are capable of performing photosynthesis, or they are capable of photosynthesizing their own food, this kind of chlorenchyma is known as this kind of parenchyma is known as chlorenchyma. And of course, if you look at the locations of these chlorenchyma, so where will they be found? They will be found in leaves and other green parts of the plant. Right? Then one more modification of parenchyma is there, and that modification of parenchyma is known as Aerenchyma. So what is Aerenchyma? These are the parenchyma cells that have trapped air and provide buoyancy. That helps aquatic plants to float. So these kind of parenchyma cells are known as Aerenchyma. Those parenchyma that have trapped air, and because of this air, they become lighter and they provide buoyancy to the aquatic plants, because of which the aquatic plants, they float on the surface of water. These kind of parenchyma are known as Aerenchyma, right? So, if you look at the functions of parenchyma, so first of all, it is a basic packaging tissue. Right? And due to large intercellular spaces, it helps in efficient exchange of respiratory gases, right? So, as you have seen that parenchyma cells have large intercellular spaces, and in these large intercellular spaces, it ensures that every cell is getting sufficient amount of oxygen and every cell is losing its carbon dioxide easily. So, in other words, you can say it increases the efficiency of exchange of respiratory gases. That is the function. And of course, provides support and mechanical strength and it stores the important materials like proteins, etc., and of course, it stores the waste as gum, gelatin, etc., right? So these all are the functions of parenchyma cell, the basic packaging tissue, and because of large intercellular spaces, it helps in efficient exchange of respiratory gases. It also provides support and mechanical strength to the plant, and it is responsible for storing some important materials like proteins, amino acids, starch, etc. And of course, it also stores the waste material like gum, gelatin, etc. And then other function of parenchyma tissue you have seen in the form of chlorenchyma and Aerenchyma. Chlorenchyma helps in photosynthesis and Aerenchyma provides buoyancy to the aquatic plants, right? So that is all about parenchyma. And next type of supportive simple permanent tissues are collenchyma. So now let's have a look at collenchyma. So if you look at the collenchyma cells, these collenchyma are also elongated living cells with cell wall irregularly thickened at corners due to deposition of pectin and cellulose, and this pectin and cellulose together is known as pectocellulose. So you can say that the collenchyma cells are cylindrical shaped cells, and their cell walls are irregularly thickened at corners. So you can see somewhat like this. You can find the chlorenchyma cells having thickened cell walls at the corners, and this thickening is due to deposition of material pectocellulose, which is basically a combination of pectin and cellulose, right? If you look at the transverse section, they may be oval, they may be hexagonal, or any other shape you can observe there. So, and of course, due to deposition of that pectocellulose, they are having very small intercellular spaces. Right, so as there is deposition of pectocellulose, and due to this pectocellulose, their intercellular spaces has been reduced. They have become very small. And if you look at the location of collenchyma, it is found at stalks of leaves and branches, and it is also found in the midribs of leaves. If you look at the leaves of a dicot plant, so in dicot plant the leaves have got the reticulate venation. So here this is known as midrib, and this midrib is having collenchyma, right? And another interesting thing, these collenchyma are absent in the stems of monocots. You cannot see collenchyma in the stems of monocots. And if you look at the functions of collenchyma, provides rigidity, support, and flexibility. that is the function of Collenchyma. So, the Collenchyma, they provide the mechanical support, they also provide the rigidity as well as they provide the flexibility, and they also help in growth and elongation of the plant. So that is all the function of Collenchyma, right? So Collenchyma, as I said, they are again living cells having elongated cells, and their cell walls are irregularly thickened at corners due to deposition of pectocellulose. Pectocellulose, as you know, is a combination of pectin and cellulose. And if you find its location, they can be obtained or found at the stalks of leaves and branches, and also in the midribs of the leaves, but they are absent in the stems of monocots, right? If you look at the function of Collenchyma, they provide mechanical support, rigidity as well as flexibility to the plant, and also they help in the growth and elongation of the plant, right? And third type of tissues which you can observe here, of the type of supportive simple permanent tissues, and these are what? Third type of supportive permanent tissues are Sclerenchyma. So if you look at the structures of Sclerenchyma, so Sclerenchyma cells are dead cells spindle shaped. If you look at the shape of Sclerenchyma, they look somewhat like this, and their cell wall is very much thick due to deposition of the cell wall, which is made up of cellulose, is having deposition of lignin, right? And due to deposition of lignin, there is no cell cavity, there are no intercellular spaces, they neither contain any cytoplasm nor they contain any nucleus. So here you can say cell wall is very thick due to lignin deposition, no intercellular spaces, no cell cavity, no nucleus, and of course no cytoplasm, right? So that is that all are the features of Sclerenchyma. And if you look at the locations, so you can find Sclerenchyma in all the hard parts, like you can take the example of coconut husk, and seed covers. So you must have seen the hard fiber-like structures present on the surface of coconut. So these hard fiber-like structures are due to presence of Sclerenchyma in them. And also Some of the seeds like groundnut, they have got hard covering. If you talk about walnut, they're also having the hard covering, and that is also made up of Sclerenchyma. And now if you look at the function, as they are hard, so of course their function is to provide support and rigidity, right? So that is the function of Sclerenchyma, right? So that is all about all type of simple permanent supportive tissues, that is Parenchyma, Collenchyma and Sclerenchyma. In our next lecture we will be discussing about the protective type of simple permanent tissues, that are epidermis and cork, right? So have a nice time. Goodbye till then.